You should probably back up your Facebook account. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. One of my more popular articles and popular video is how do I recover my hacked Facebook account? I often hear from folks who have lost access to their Facebook accounts for one reason or another. Sometimes they lose access to the only copy they have of their photos and more. The only copy. That implies they're in only one place. Those photos, those videos exist only in their Facebook account. So when you lose your Facebook account, you lose all your photos and videos. They weren't backed up. That's not good. I've said it over and over again. You can lose everything forever if you've only got it in one place. Now, it's really easy to become complacent and assume your account will always be there. Particularly if you think you're doing everything correctly, you might believe there's little risk. Little risk is not the same as no risk. You could lose your Facebook account in ways that are not under your control. It could get hacked. Yes, if you have appropriate security, most notably two-factor authentication, then getting hacked is not a huge threat, though it still remains a risk. More commonly, though, I hear from people who haven't set up two-factor or recovery information or who didn't keep the recovery information current. They're the ones who end up losing their account forever. Now, this is new. Your account could get suspended for policy violations. This is frustrating because all too often, the violations aren't violations at all. The Facebook content moderation AI seems to have gone a little nuts and is flagging otherwise completely benign posts as violating the rules. Of course, if you violate the rules regularly, you could easily have your account suspended. The real concern here is that even if you're playing by all the rules, Facebook itself might go off the rails and take your account with it. Of course, there are other ways to lose access to your account, but those two are the ones I think are worth worrying about. There's more to your Facebook account than you might realize. You've got your photos and videos, you've got messages and conversations, friends lists and contacts, the posts you've made and the status updates you've created, events and calendar information, and of course, pages and groups that you manage. If you lose your account for any reason, all that is gone. Period. Now, the simplest way to back up your Facebook information is to use Facebook's own tool. It's called, unimaginatively, Download Your Information. In the desktop version of Facebook, visit this URL. I've pasted it here into my address bar. It's theaccountcenter.facebook.com/info_and_permissions. Now, before I go any further, I do want to throw out the usual caveat. Facebook is known for changing things from time to time. So if what we're about to describe doesn't work, or if it doesn't contain the process exactly below, search Facebook settings for the option to download your information. Use perhaps some of the strings or keywords you'll see in what exists today, so you'll be able to find it tomorrow if it moves. Once you're in the Accounts Center, click on Download Your Information. Now, click on Download or Transfer Information. This thing here in the middle is actually a button to click on. Now, if you have multiple things in your account's control, for example, I have my personal Facebook, it's connected to my personal Instagram, and of course, there's this new Meta account that's kind of both but neither. Anyway, these are all things that are associated with your current login. Select which ones you want to download. My recommendation, as you can imagine, is to select them all. Click on Next. Once again, you now have an option of defining how much you want to include in the download. My recommendation, of course, is to click on Available Information. That will download everything. However, if you click on Specific Types of Information, it's going to walk you through a selection process to let you pick and choose what you want. That might be appropriate, for example, if you know you only want your photos, for example. But I'm going to click on Available Information. So now we need to define a little bit more about how we want this stuff downloaded. We get to choose a date range, which is actually kind of interesting. It's useful if we're doing this periodically, so you don't have to download everything. If you've never done this, I strongly recommend you select all time. If you're doing this periodically, like say maybe you're doing it once a month or once every 3 months, those are great options to just get like the last month or last 3 months or whatever of the data without having it download absolutely everything. In my case, like I said, all time. I want it all. The other thing is this format. You'll have this option to choose HTML or JSON. Honestly, unless you know you want something else, use HTML. And finally, media quality. If it's present, you want high quality. You want as close to the original videos and images as is possible. Click on Save, and now we'll click on Create Files. All right, now you can see back on this Download Your Information dialog, we now have current activity. And you can see that this is in progress. We have a download of everything in my Facebook account. Now you'll notice that mine was created in February the 1st of 2005. Well, given that it's currently today, October the 24th of 2024, we're looking at 19 years worth of information. This is going to take some time. In my experiment running up to this, actually trying this out before I show you, my download was available roughly 2 or 3 days after requesting it. You'll get notified, that's not an issue, but be patient. Presumably, if you're doing one of the shorter time frames, say the last 3 months or the last year or whatever, it'll be quicker. Or if you just weren't as active on Facebook as I've been, then it might be smaller and it might be quicker. But once again, it's going to take some time. One of the counter arguments I'm going to make, and this is very uncharacteristic for my continuing to evangelize about backing up, is that maybe you don't need to back up Facebook. I say that because it's very possible you're really only concerned about certain things in your Facebook account. For example, most people are concerned about losing their photos and their videos. When they express that concern, it's usually because they've uploaded the images to Facebook and then deleted the originals. Don't do that. Independent of anything I'm saying here, never delete your originals. There's a bunch of reasons that you really don't want to do that. Archive them or back them up somehow, but never trust Facebook or any other social media platform as the only repository for your precious memories. Like I said, you could lose access to your account. But interesting, even more than that, many of these platforms, including Facebook, actively reduce the quality of the images you upload. In other words, what you upload will end up looking maybe a little fuzzier than the original. Even if you download it again later, including this backup, you're not getting the image with the same quality you uploaded in the first place. So I'll say it again, never delete your originals. Now, if you don't care about your other activities, such as your messages, your comments, your contacts, and all that kind of stuff, if all you care about is the media you've shared, then by never deleting the originals, you won't lose anything should you lose your Facebook account. In that case, yeah, it's perfectly valid to choose not to back up your Facebook account at all. Bottom line, back up or not, but make it a conscious decision based on what you would lose should your Facebook account be lost. And independently, never delete the originals. No matter how else you use them or where else you share them, keep the originals. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/175246. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.